The HP-50g and the HP-49g both come from the factory in algebraic mode. To access the full power of this handheld computer, I advise you to set it up as follows. Click on the mode key and a big dialog screen appears. The first change is that of the operating mode. It says algebraic here and we want RPM. The function keys F1 through F6 have soft labels that tell us what their current function is. We click F2, choose, and a pull-down menu appears in which we can choose between algebraic mode and RPM mode. With the down arrow, this one, we choose RPM mode, which is the one we will be using all the time, the one in which all the power of the HP50 opens to us, and click OK. Done, we are in RPM mode. We keep going. The next stop is numeric format. It comes from the factory in standard mode, which is fine most of the time. You are free to leave it like that or change it. Personally, I prefer to choose a different one, and we come to the choose button, F2, choose, standard, fixed point, scientific or engineering mode. I will choose fixed mode. Okay, how many digits? Choose the decimal places to display. Well, for the screen, I prefer 2. Even though for an exam, you may want to use 3 or 4. Moving on. Angle measure, radiance is fine. Coordinate systems, rectangular is okay. And how about beeping? Well, personally, I don't like all the beeping, and I don't think your prof or your classmates appreciate that either, so I will turn it off. You see it's check marked. I have the check key in F2, check, is a toggle. Let's leave it unchecked. Okay with that. But let's not press OK yet, because we still have ways to go. Now we enter into the sub-dialog CAS, the Calculator Algebraic System. Click there, and we enter into that one. A new dialog appears, the CAS modes. The CAS modes, we're going to leave all of them blanked, except the approx one. So with the arrow keys, we go to complex, we uncheck that one, make sure that the only option that is checked is approx. Here is a check key, F3, and then we press OK to go back to the previous menu that's already set. We don't leave yet, we still have works to do. We go to flags with the function key F1. Flags. Flags are switches or flags that tell the calculator what kind of setup is your preferred configuration, your personal preferences. Some of these you will check or uncheck depending on how you like the calculator to work for you. Let me tell you what works for me. For now, I recommend you that you do as I do, and then as you get used to it, you will change it. The first flag that we will change is flag 22. Right now, if a result gives an infinite number, like 1 divided by 0, the calculator will report an error. I don't like that. I prefer that the calculator gives me a semi-infinite value, a huge value, and I click check. That way, a program that is operating will not stop. It will continue to operate and give me an engineer's result. So I click on flag 22. The next stop is, I keep going. I keep going. stop. The next stop is flag 40. You see, in flag 40, if I check that, I show the clock. I like seeing the clock on my screen. And I also like my clock to be a 24-hour clock, so I'm going to check this one too. And on we go, checking many other flags, like flag 53, check. Flag 55, check. Flag 56, check. Flag 72. Well, flag 72, check. Flag 73, check. Flag 80, check. 82, check. Check. 90, check. 98. Well, 95 should be unchecked, right? Unchecked. 98, check. 105. 111 is check. 116. Check. 117, checked already. 119, check. And 120, silent mode off, check. And we are ready to leave that. Now we say okay, and okay. And our calculator is all set and ready to go. Thank you very much.